I was amazed. And I said, I need to get these out of here.
That Cape Coral man discovered 9 pipe bombs in a golf bag a neighbor gave him. NBC2 broke this story last night at 11 after the bomb squad was called to a home off Northwest 27th Street. The neighborhood was put on lockdown for nearly 4 hours as the bomb squad moved in with their robot to detonate those explosives. You can't see much in the cell phone video, but you hear the loud booms as the bombs detonate. What makes the story so bizarre, the golf bag was a gift from an unsuspecting neighbor.
Before we brought it to her house, I went through the bag and I took everything out of the bag. And I had those things in my hand. I just didn't know what they were.
Tonight, we have live team coverage. Holly Hojack shows us what was inside the bombs that made the situation even more dangerous. But we begin with NBC2's Jim Spiewak live in Cape Coral. He spoke with the woman whose husband found those bombs.
Okay, so guys, this is the garage that those golf clubs were in for almost 2 months, and just 20 feet right across the street from their driveway is where they threw the bag after the pipe bombs were discovered. As you can see, there's still some golf balls, some tees, a golf glove over here, remnants from that bag. Very, very scary situation. I spoke with the wife of the husband who found the bag, and she tells me that this whole thing, she believes, is the product of a neighbor who is now deceased, but before he died, they said that she was pretty ill. What do you do when a neighbor offers you equipment of a sport you don't even play?
Her husband had died. She said, why don't you take them? I said, okay, so we took them.
If you're as polite as Ellen Sue Burton, you take the used golf bag and clubs.
We don't play golf, but I knew someone that does, so I just left them in the garage.
But when friends declined to take them, the Burtons looked a little closer.
I opened up the side pouch, and I saw 6 pipe bombs in one pouch. And 3 pipe bombs in another pouch.
And it was at that moment reality sank in. They had been housing a ticking time bomb for nearly 2 months.
This is dangerous business.
The bomb squad safely detonated all 9 bombs Wednesday night. Now that the dust has settled, all the Burtons can think about is their recently deceased neighbor's intentions.
I plead the 5th Amendment on it. I really do.
But you have, in your mind, you do have some reservations.
I do have a lot of reservations.
But there is no reservation when it comes to a new family policy of golf bags in the house.
Right. None. Zero.
So back out here live, speaking with the homeowners here, they're not upset over this whole situation. They just want to move on with their life, and they're happy that no one was injured or, thankfully, no one was killed in this whole incident. As for when I asked them why they think a neighbor might make homemade pipe bombs, the only explanation they could come up with is the fact that this person was battling cancer, they say, and that he was heavily medicated at the time. We're reporting live in Cape Coral. Jim Spiewak, NBC 2 News.
He just took the clubs out of the golf bag, and there's pipe bombs inside.
Ooh. That was one of the 911 calls. It took almost 4 hours to get the bombs and detonate them. Today we learned what was inside the pipes made them extremely dangerous. Holly Hojack continues our live team coverage from the NBC2 control room.
Kelly, the Southwest Florida Regional Bomb Squad says 99% of the time, these types of suspicious package or bomb threat calls are false alarms, but there's that 1% chance it's a live explosive. Last night, it was 9 live bombs.
Bomb squad detonated them, so I would say that they worked.
9 pipe bombs just waiting to explode inside a golf bag in a Cape Coral man's garage.
The biggest issue with these devices were they had fragmentation inside of them.
The Southwest Florida Regional Bomb Squad was called in to remove the deadly devices last night. We learned today the homemade bombs were made from PVC pipe with caps on both ends and a fuse in the middle.
Best way I could describe it would be a large plastic firecracker.
Some thought went into it other than just an average pipe bomb, you might say.
Inside, the real danger, cut up shotgun shells and black powder.
All depends on how that piece of fragmentation flies, the true danger and the distance.
Earlier this month, the bomb squad responded in Cape Coral after an explosion at a condo. A man is still recovering after blowing off both of his arms.
If you don't know 100%, you shouldn't mess with it.
Last night, the bomb squad evacuated part of the 4500 block of Northwest 27th Street. They set up a 1,000-foot perimeter and brought in the robot.
We remotely unzipped the pouches on the side of the golf bag and removed the pipes out of the golf bag, which is a pretty difficult thing to do.
It took the bomb squad just under 4 hours to safely remove and detonate all 9 pipe bombs.
What this reminds us of is that law enforcement in the 21st century is a very, very different animal. We have to constantly adjust and adapt and learn.
Now, we learned today pipe bombs do not go bad. Despite these bombs being made months ago, they still exploded. If you do find a pipe bomb or something similar, law enforcement says leave it alone, do not move it, and call 911 immediately. Live in the control room tonight, Holly Hojek, NBC2.